Hi guys, welcome everyone. My name is Vera and today I'm going to show you how to draw a delicious looking ice cream with a cherry on top. Now remember, this is a video tutorial, so if at any point you need to pause it to give yourself enough time for any step, please do that. You don't have to complete it in one sitting. This video is going to remain right here on our YouTube. It's not going anywhere, so you can come back and do it anytime. And also, you guys are more than welcome to use any other colors and decorate your ice cream however you want. I'm going to be showing you what I did specifically when I was creating this drawing, but also again, feel free to experiment, feel free to add a blueberry on top instead of cherry, or a strawberry, or a raspberry, or honestly anything else, piece of chocolate, anything else that you would like. And the same goes for flavors. You can add your own flavors, you can add some sprinkles, wherever your imagination takes you, that's where you can go with this. So before we start, let's go through all our supplies to make sure we have everything that we need for today. First thing you're going to need is a piece of paper. When I was creating this, I originally made it on the drawing paper. It was 8 by 10 inch drawing paper. However, today I'm going to try a different paper and I'm going to use mixed media paper, and this one is 7 by 10, so it's not a big difference. It's very similar in size, and this one is actually a little bit more yellow and this one is a little bit more white paper, but again, it doesn't make a big difference, as you can see. So just grab some appropriate paper or any paper. All right, then second thing that you're going to need is you're going to need a regular HB pencil, because we're going to start with a sketch and we're just going to sketch everything with just a regular HB pencil. So make sure you have that. Plus, of course, you want to have an eraser and a sharpener, just in case you need to sharpen your pencil or erase any lines that you made. So I'm going to put those aside. In addition to those, we're going to need a ruler, because there are quite a few straight lines here. I mean, it's not super necessary for you to have a ruler, but it is always good to have. So make sure you have that, and we're gonna start with a straight middle line to make sure our ice cream ends up symmetrical and, you know, just not tilted one way or another. But again, it's not super necessary to have, but always good to have. So make sure you have a ruler if you would like, and if you have one. We're also gonna need a Q-tip or some sort of smudger. Q-tip is a very common thing to have in house, so grab one or a few if you have one. And you're gonna need a paper towel, or just reuse, or just like any piece of paper to put your hand on it, so A, you don't rub the oils from your hand onto your paper, or and B, so you don't smudge everything with your hand. So whenever possible, whenever you remember, ideally always try to use a piece of paper or a piece of paper towel underneath your hand as you draw. And let's talk about the colors that we're going to use. I'm going to use a variety of colors today, and I'm going to show you which colors I'm going to be using, so you can match to the best of your ability, but of course you can replace them with any color that you want. So I'm going to start with the cherry colors. For the cherry colors, I'm going to need three different colors. I'm going to need two different reds. I'm going to use light red and a dark red, and I'm going to need one brown for the stem. And also, I'm going to use this brown for my chocolate. Well, I will use a few different browns for my chocolate, but this is one of the browns that I will be using for my chocolate as well. So I'm going to use this for the cherry and for the chocolate. So again, that's just light red, dark red, and warm reddish brown. But again, it can be any brown. So those are my three colors. The next couple colors that I'm going to use is going to be my ice cream cone colors. And for my ice cream cone, I'm going to use a few different colors again. I'm going to use beigey brown. So do you see, it's like, I would say it's beigey light, golden, light golden brown. And I'm going to use dark cold brown. And I'm going to use this one for the chocolate too. So basically all these colors I'm going to use for my cone and my chocolate. So I'm using this yellowy golden light brown, almost sand color. I'm using this cold dark brown, and I'm using this reddish dark brown. This is for my cone and my chocolate. And I will be using brown for the outline here too. However, I'm going to be using this one, the cold brown, because you see it almost looks like gray because it's pretty cold. However, if you prefer, you can grab a gray or use just your HB pencil or black, whatever you prefer for that. So here's ice cream cone and chocolate colors. And now we're going to move on to our ice cream colors. And this is the colors that I'm going to be using for my ice cream. I'm going to set them up in the way that makes the most sense, I guess. All right, so here are my colors. And I'm going to be making warm pink, cold pink. So two different pinks for my two different flavors. So I'm going to use this color. This is a very light, almost like a beige color. It's, yeah, the most similar to nude, I would say. I will use this nude color as a base for these two layers. And I'm going to use this color as the most visible color there. I would say this is like a light pink, but on a warmer side. It's almost like closer a bit to a fair skin tone color. So light warm pink. So it has that bit of tint of yellow in it. So it has like a little bit of a coral or peach undertone to it. So I'm gonna use that one for these two colors as well. This one I'm gonna be using for all three layers of ice cream. This one I would say is a just nice shade of nice pastel-ish. I mean, it's fairly visible and fairly vibrant, but it's not a hot pink either. So it still has like a pastel undertone to it. Yeah, so this is gonna be my next pink. And this one is gonna tie all three layers together. And this too, the cold pinks, they're a bit closer to magenta. They even have like a hint of fuchsia or maybe even like a hint of purpleness to them, are gonna be for this layer. But of course, you're welcome to replace. You can do, let's say, this two blue and this two purple. You can do this two pink and this one purple, or you can go contrast. You can do yellow, orange, red. I mean, you choose your own colors. You just make sure for every color that you choose, let's say you want to do three different colors for your ice cream, you want to have at least two tones. So you want to have a lighter version, darker version, and if you have a super dark version, you can use that as an addition. So two to three colors, two to three tones for every single color that you choose to do. So make sure you have that. And that's pretty much it, guys. That's all our supplies that we're gonna need. And you can put them aside for now. You don't need to use them just yet. We just went through them so you guys know what to grab and what to prepare, and then we're gonna move to our drawing and we're gonna start with the sketch. All right, so I'm gonna grab my paper here. I'll put this one away, but you guys can refer on the image that you can see on your screen. And we are going to start. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to grab a ruler and we're gonna put a line right in the middle of our paper. My paper actually is. It actually starts somewhere right here. So I'm gonna rip it right away so it doesn't confuse us. There's just a bit of extra space there. All right, and actually going to use this under. Awesome. So I'm going to grab my ruler and I'm going to put one vertical line. It's just a regular HB pencil right in the middle. You don't have to measure anything out. It doesn't have to be precise. As long as it's one straight vertical line, it's good. Or one straight-ish. In my case, this is not actually the middle, so I'm going to redo it. Because now that I edit, I feel like it's a little to the right. So let's redo this. I think middle would be somewhere right here. All right. Take two. Perfect. So do you see I have one straight vertical line right in the middle. Now I'm going to decide where my ice cream starts and where my cone starts and where they connect. So I would say right in the middle vertically, I'm going to put a little dot. So I think it's somewhere around here. Yeah, that looks about right. That would be where my ice cream connects to my cone. So right in the middle. So now that I know that, I'm going to start adding my cone. And I'm going to decide how far down I'm going to go with my cone. Really up to you. You can go this far, that far. Totally up to you. It really depends how big you want your cone to be. But I'm going to go pretty far. I'm going to go until maybe right here. And I'm going to, second thing I'm going to do, I'm going to decide how wide my cone is going to be. So I put a little line right here. And just make sure you do it the same distance on the left and the right. So maybe like this. But again, it's totally up to you, and you can either measure it with a ruler if you have one, or you can measure it with a pencil like this, or you can just eyeball it and see that it's about the same distance on the left and on the right. And once we have that, we're going to take our ruler and we're going to connect. You know what? This is actually might be a little bit too far. I'm going to shorten it up a touch. I think this is better. Okay. Happy with this. And now I'm just going to connect those dots with the bottom dot. One, two. Awesome. That's my cone, or at least that's a base for my cone. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to start drawing my ice cream. And I'm going to have, I'm going to start by making something that looks like a ball. So it's going to start here and it's going to go up like this. It doesn't have to be perfect at all. And ideally you want it just a little bit wider than your cone. Right, so something like that. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect at all. In fact, we're going to erase half of it, so you're not going to see it. So just add circle-ish shape. It's not a perfect circle. It's not a big deal. All right, I'm happy with my shape. I'm going to clean it up just a touch here. All right, awesome. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to keep about half, maybe a little bit less than half of the shape. It's going to be the top part of my ice cream. So this is approximately, or maybe a little bit more, maybe like this much is what I'm going to keep untouched. This is just going to be half circular. And now from here, I'm going to start adding those, what looks like skirt almost. And I'm going to start by adding a really small one. So it's just going to stick out a little bit on each side. You see like a little curve, and then I'm gonna curve up at the top a little bit to make it less straight and less even, and then I'm gonna add the bottom. And because this edge is uneven from scooping the ice cream, make sure you make it that way. You don't want it even, and it doesn't have to look exactly like my drawing. Just make sure it's uneven. You don't have to repeat precisely the unevenness that I'm creating. Then next one is going to be a little bit wider. It's not going to be as short. So again, I'm going to start by putting a little curved line on the side. And then last one is going to be the widest. So very similar, but just the widest one. Alright, so I have all three. So let me erase all the lines that I don't want anymore, and then I'm going to adjust them. So let's erase our middle line. We don't need it anymore. We're going to erase all the other unnecessary lines, and then we're going to finalize our shape. So we're going to look at it again, and see, do we like it? If we don't like it, then we're gonna adjust it and make it the way we like it, and only then we're gonna move to our next step, which is gonna be cherry. We're gonna sketch cherry, we're gonna sketch the bottom of our cone, and we're gonna sketch chocolate. All right, I'm happy with the shape. I like it. And do you see how these lines are not straight? So that's what you want. You don't want them to be straight because this ice cream is curved, right? So every single line here has to be somewhat curved. You cannot use straight lines because it's not going to look like this is a circle. All right, I'm happy with this. Now let's move on to our cherry. I'm going to put a cherry on top. But again, if you guys want to do a raspberry or a blueberry or any other, like you can put a candy, you can put a piece of chocolate, you can put like a wafer, honestly any treat or any fruit or any berry, you can do that instead of cherry. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start by putting almost like a circle, but more like a squished circle on top. So you see it's a little squished circle on top, and you see it's crossing my ice cream. And now I'm gonna add a little den on top. So I'm gonna make a little like line curved down a very slightly right here. All right, and this is gonna be where our little stem gonna come from. And I'm gonna outline very lightly a glare as well right away. So I'm gonna add a tiny glare here and a tiny glare here. And you can outline them. This is what it looks like. And then I'm gonna add a stem. So just a little curved line, and I'm gonna add a bit of sauce underneath. It's gonna be my sauce. All right, now that I have that, I'm gonna move lower and I'm gonna move on to my ice cream, and we're gonna add ice cream drips. So because this ice cream has, chocolate drips, because this chocolate is thick, it's gonna stick out a bit on our sides. And then you're just gonna add drip of any shape. Make sure there's a variety of sizes too. Some drips should be longer, some drips should be shorter. So we're looking for that, and then you're gonna erase those lines underneath. So do you see how it's sticking out on the sides? That's what you want. And then the last thing that we have left here is our bottom, and that's going to be our cone. So what you're going to start with is you're going to add another line a little bit further, so from this corner until maybe somewhere right here, you're going to add a second line. Do you see parallel? Well, it's not parallel because it brings to the same line. Do you see what I mean? It starts at the same dot but goes a little bit further away from this line. And you're going to do the same thing on both sides, and they can be either on the same distance, either the same height or slightly different. Some one can be slightly shorter, one can be taller. That's not a problem. They don't have to be the same height, but they can be. And then I'm going to do from here, I'm gonna put a line until around here. Connect this to the top. So you connect this to the top, bring a line here. From here, I'm gonna put line here and here. So do you see a created corner? And now I'm gonna add one more line from here down and another line. So this is what it looks like up close. And of course, guys, if you need a bit more time, feel free to pause this, give yourself enough time, and then I'm going to erase this line, this line, and this line. So everything underneath, you're going to erase. Ta-da! And that's our ice cream. So my outline is done. Now I would say take a really good look at it and see if anything needs to be adjusted. And if it does, adjust it. You want to have your outline the way you like it before we move to coloring part. Because once we move to coloring part, you're not really going to be able to change much from there. So it's best to adjust it and make the way you like it before we move any further. So for me personally, I'm quite happy with it. So the only thing that I'm going to do here is I'm going to actually lighten up my sketch. So I don't see any harsh outlines once we finished. I don't like seeing harsh outlines. So do you see, I can still see my sketch. I didn't lose my lines, but they're definitely way less visible. That way I'm not gonna have any harsh outline after I am done. So, and that's pretty much it. I'm gonna move on to my coloring part now. All right, so for the coloring, I'm gonna start with my ice cream and I'm gonna start with the lightest part of it. So I'm gonna grab that light. So do you remember our ice cream colors, right? So again, you can use the colors of your choice. Just make sure you use lighter and darker colors. So at least two shades for every single color you decide to go with. So I'm gonna go with the lightest color. This one that looks like almost like a cream slash nude color. This is what I'm gonna start with. And I'm gonna very, very lightly color in this entire layer, but super, super, super lightly. You see, you can barely see it. And the same with this one. And you see how I'm holding my pencil almost parallel to the paper. That way I don't see too many lines. And once I have that, you see very, very lightly, it's super, super light. I'm gonna grab a Q-tip and I'm just gonna smudge all of that. Right, and after this, I'm gonna start shading it. So I'm gonna shade my edge a little bit. And you don't have to shade the whole edge. You can shade just the bottom. You can keep the top darker. You can shade the whole thing if you wanted to. And I'm going to shade this edge too. So from the shade, from the edge in, I'm going to make the edge darkest, and then I'm going to make a little gradient going towards the inside. Again, you can do the whole edge or just part of it. And I'm going to bring it a little bit further here. So just on this part, above this line. So I'm going to shade this pretty much this whole part. I'm going to make it closer actually, guys. Give me a second, let's get a little closer here. All right, so we can see it better. So do you see I'm shading from this line pretty much up. But still very lightly, and this is a very light color in general, so you can't see it too much. All right, that's good. And now I'm going to do something very similar to this part. I'm going to shade it pretty much from the edge in, but mostly from the bottom edge and from the side, so not as much from the top. You can do a little bit from the top, but mostly it's going to be from the bottom edge and from the sides. And again, don't use the full pressure of your pencil. Do it quite lightly. You're basically going a little bit darker at the edge and then you're spreading it towards the inside. You see it's starting to get shape. And then we're gonna do the same thing to the bottom part too. We're gonna shade it from the outside in, so from the edge in. Alright, so do you see I shaded from the edge in on all my sections that will be the same color? And again, yours can be completely different color. Just gonna use the lightest version of that color for that. Alright, now I'm gonna grab my eraser and I'm just gonna clean up a little bit because it accidentally got in some other areas where I don't want it to be. Alright, done. And now I'm gonna move on to my second color. Oh, by the way, you can smudge this all with a Q-tip or you don't have to, it doesn't really matter, but it doesn't hurt to smudge this because it's just the beginning, right? However, I'm gonna be avoiding the lighter areas. All right, done. So now I'm gonna move on to my second color. So this is gonna be my second color. Well, let me make some more a spot here where I can show you just colors. So this is my first one, right, that I used here. This is my second one. Oh, sorry. Sorry, guys, that's my third one. This is my second one. Here it is. So this is the one I'm going to use right now. You see, it's a little bit darker than my first one. It's like pink, but on a warmer side. So it still has almost like a tint of peachy color or coral color to it. Yeah, this is what it looks like. So this is what I'm going to use for my second one. And with this color, I'm going to start at shading in a very similar way, but I'm not going to do it as even. So I'm going to create more uneven shading. So again, I'm going to start with the edge and I'm going to shade the edge, but I'm going to shade only a couple spots here. So I'm going to shade a spot here from the edge in again. And I'm gonna shade a spot here from the edge in, and maybe a little spot right here, but very lightly. So you go quite lightly with this. Now I'm gonna start creating those little, almost like a dims in ice cream, because the ice cream, the whole surface is not even. So we're gonna try to make it uneven by creating a little areas that we shade with this pencil. And you're only gonna use maybe like a 30% of the pressure, so don't, or even less, like 20 to 30% of the pressure on this pencil. So you don't want to push too hard because you don't want those areas to be too dark. We're going to start building light and we're going to cover the whole ice cream with those little things. But keep in mind, the top needs to be generally lighter, so you go easier there. You can still add one or two, but super, super lightly. And don't overdo it there. This edge too. I'm gonna add a couple spots. And then I'm gonna start darkening up this bottom. So I'm gonna add a bit of shading from the edge up, but it's not gonna be even like we did the first time. First time we went pretty even everywhere. This time certain areas are gonna have a bit more Certain areas are going to have a bit less. So it's way more uneven. I'm going to shade this corner a little bit higher actually, just a touch, and this one too, to maintain this rounded shape of my ice cream. Maybe I'll shade just a little bit at the very top too, from where my sauce is going to be. And you can push a little bit harder, closer to this line, so you can push and make it a bit more visible and a bit more contrast here. All right, so my top is pretty much done. Now I'm going to move on to this section here, and I'm going to do something very similar to what I did first time, but again, less even and with more pressure. So I'm going to shade it from the edges in, but it's going to be a bit more uneven. Again, from the top, I'm going to go quite easy there. I will do a little bit of shading here and there, but not a large amount. That one is going to be almost untouched with just a touch of shading in a couple spots, but I'm going to go much heavier on the sides and the bottom. See, I'm shading from the bottom up, and in certain areas I'm adding a lot more, in certain areas way less, because again, we want this to be uneven too. We do want to have the lightest spots that are you know, just more like a glare where the light reflects the most. We want to have that uneven surface, and the only way you're going to get uneven surface if you don't create the even shading. So certain areas need to be darker, like almost like a spots that are darker and spots that are lighter. That way you can tell that certain areas are deeper in and certain areas are closer to you, sticking out more. All right, so this is pretty good. I think I could go a bit heavier on this. Maybe I'll make it a little more uneven, do you see? I'm still keeping certain areas completely white or like super, super light. And certain areas, I'm just completely shading the whole thing, but I'm keeping the darkest edge and everything closer to the edge. All right, so I did this here, and I'm going to do something very similar on the very bottom part. So again, I'm gonna shade everything from the edge in first, and then as I do the certain areas, I'm gonna go further, in certain areas I'm gonna go less. Because I want to end up with very uneven surface in the end. All right, so I'm just making it a little less even because I feel like it's still a little too even. So I'm just going to shade a couple more spots. All right, I'm happy with this. So I'm done pretty much with this color. I'm gonna put it aside. That was my second one. Now I'm gonna move on to this one, which is my third one. So where is it? Where is it? Here it is. So this one is very nice and vibrant pink. It's almost hot pink, but it's still a little bit more on a pastel side versus the true hot pink. But it's pretty out there, as you can see. And with this one, I'm gonna go over the same areas, but I'm gonna add minimal amount of this and only on areas that I would like to have a bit darker. So for example, right here, I'm gonna darken up a touch, right? So the anything that you would like a little bit darker, you're gonna darken up with this color just a little bit. So it's the same principle, but you're adding way, way less of it. And on the areas that are already pretty dark, you can add even darker smidge of something. All right, that's it, or at least for now, that's it. Once I move forward, and if I feel like I don't have enough here, once we have everything else, I will go back and I'll add some. But for now, I'm quite okay with this. I think this looks good, so don't think I want to be adding much more for a little bit until I have all the other colors laid out. And then I'll revisit and see if I do want to add a bit more. All right, and now I'm gonna move on to this layer of ice cream, and I'm gonna oh, I will put this one here too, just so I can see my three colors. One, two, three. Right, great. Let's erase that so it's not too confusing. All right, great. Now I'm gonna move on to this inner layer, and here are my three colors that I'm going to use. So again, I'm going to start with this two color, lighter and darker. So this is just a really beautiful shade of pink. They're a bit more close to purple versus the ones that I've been using before that are a bit closer to like red and orange. These ones are a bit more on a cooler side. They have like almost a tint of purple to them. And then this color that we just used right now, this one, I'm gonna use that one too, just tie everything together. So I'm going to start with this one. It's going to be my first color. You see cold, beautiful pink. Then my second one is going to be this. It's like a darker, almost purple version. And then the third one, I'm going to use the exact same one that I used on top. So I'm going to start with pretty much what we did before with this color. So I'm going to do super, super light shading the entire thing using my pencil pretty low to the paper. I'm going to shade the whole thing lightly. Then I'm going to grab my Q-tip and I'm going to smudge all of this. So I have a nice even base. And then I'm going to start shading from the edge in with the same color. So again, it's very similar to what we did on top. So it's the same order of steps. It's exact same steps. It's just different colors. All right, so the first layer is done. Do you see? It's nice uneven shading from the edge in. Maybe in certain areas I'll even shade the whole thing. Again, to break it up a little and have some spots that are lower and some spots that are higher. All right, and I'm gonna put this pencil aside and I'm gonna move on to my second one, which is gonna be this one. It's pretty much the same darkness, just different shade. This one has a bit more like a purpley undertone, but this one has more like a reddish orangey undertone. And I'm gonna do the same thing as I did there on my second layer. So again, some shading from the outline in. And in certain areas you just shade more, in certain areas you shade less. Alright, if you want to smudge any of it, you absolutely can, but also you don't have to. It's entirely up to you whether you want to do that or not. Alright, and then I'm going to put aside this pencil, and I'm going to go back to this one. So the one that I used as the third pencil. I'm just going to add a bit of that here and there. Oh, sorry guys, wrong pencil. That's the one. You see, it kind of brings a little bit of the same, like a little red pop, the warm pop, to just tie everything together. might even add a bit more on nearby areas because this is the pencil that kind of ties everything together. So I might even add a bit more to the areas where it contacts with the top and the bottom. I'll shade a bit on this layer and on the upper layer too. Because again, this is the pencil that goes everywhere. But that only works if your colors are compatible. So in my case, they are compatible. So I can do that. If, let's say, you were doing a completely non-compatible color like blue and yellow, you wouldn't be doing this. You can use, like, for example, black in that case, for example. So you have a bit of shading with the darkest color, or completely skip this one. But as long as your colors are compatible, you can do that. So, for example, if you had pink and purple, blue and purple, even blue and pink, you could do purple in between because it's going to be compatible too. All right, I think that's enough for me for shading. I mean, I could shade this indefinitely. So, but at some point you just have to stop shading. So, I think that's time for me personally. I think I should stop shading sometime soon. Because again, I can do this for a long time. All right, and last little smidge here that I want to add to kind of finish up my ice cream part is actually dark brown. And it's going to be, so do you remember how I showed you that I have two browns? The one that's on a redder side and the one that's on like just a darker grayer side. I'm going to use this one actually, the one that's on a grayer side. I'm not going to use the one on a redder side, but it doesn't matter. That's just me being picky because I have options. Any brown will do as long as it's dark, and you can even alternatively use straight black. That will work just as well because I haven't personally used black at all on this drawing. I avoided it altogether. I used as my darkest color this dark brown. I'm gonna stick to my guns and do the same thing here. So this is what it looks like. That's my dark brown. So you see, it's like a cold dark brown. All right, and I'm just gonna add tiny little touch of it on the areas that supports to be the darkest to add a little more contrast to this. I'm gonna push pretty hard here because it's already a fairly dark area. So you see the little dark smidge of outline, and then you can shade a little bit if you prefer. Right. And I would say that's pretty much it for my ice cream part. So Now I'm gonna move on to my cherry. Let's do our cherry, and then we're gonna go down onto our cone and our chocolate and our little piece of paper on the bottom of the cone. So for the cherry, I'm gonna start with my light red. So do you remember how we had two shades of red and reddish brown? So let me show you right here what they're gonna look like. So that's my light red. That's my dark red. It's not super dark, but it's a little bit darker. And that's my reddish brown. So you see, it's a brown, but it has that red undertone. So those are the three colors that I'm going to be using. I'm going to start with my light red. And I'm going to start by just outlining my glares. So do you remember there were two glares that were sketched? So outline them, and after that, I'm going to shade everything lightly, but not at 100%. I'm going to shade everything at like 50%. All right, and as soon as I have this 50% shading, I'm gonna grab my Q-tip and I'm gonna smudge all of it, but I'm gonna try not to go too much over my glare. If you get a little bit on your glare, that's okay, but don't intentionally go right over it. And then I'm gonna go on to my darker red, and with the darker one, you can push pretty much at 100%. And guys, we're gonna get rid of that later and we're gonna make it at 100% the first color too. We just need to lay the rest of the colors before we do that. So I'm gonna go with my, oh, sorry guys, not that one. This, my darker red color. Oh my goodness, I keep grabbing the wrong pencil. What's wrong with me? Darker red one, so second one. Oh my goodness. Must be one of those days. So I'm gonna go right here, not to the glare, but a little bit lower and not right to the edge either. So pretty much this section here, I'm gonna color in this color, and I'm gonna add a bit of it right here, not right at the edge, but close, a little on the top right here. And a little right here. And once I have all that, then you're gonna go back to your lightest red and you're gonna color in the rest at 100%. So basically you're gonna push on your pencil as hard as you can to make it all super vibrant. And then after that, we're going to move to our brown. And I'm going to shade slightly with brown right here, the spot. And then I'm going to go super heavy right here. And here as well. And a little bit on the top there. And of course, you can add a little outline on the bottom, a touch of shading there. And our little stem. It needs to be a little bit thicker on the very end here. All right, that's our cherry, and now we can do the sauce. So the sauce you can do with any color. I'm not even gonna bother with my lightest color. I'm just gonna move on to my second one right away. I'm just gonna color in the whole sauce with my second red. You can do, again, you can do both colors. It's up to you which color you're gonna do. And then I'm gonna grab my dark brown again, and I'm gonna darken up this very bottom of the cherry and just a little bit underneath the cherry on the sauce part. All right, that's our cherry on top. So I think it's time for us to move on to our ice cream cone and our chocolate here. Now guys, my actually looks much darker. I'm looking on a video right now and this doesn't look as dark as it looks in real life, but really does look a bit more what you can see on a photo here. It looks a little darker. I think my camera is just overcorrecting the colors, but really let me just see if I can make it even darker and bring it up on a camera to the color that you should be seeing. So I'm gonna grab this other brown, this brown. Let's see if that gives me that effect, because it needs to be a little bit darker. And on my paper it does look very dark, but for some reason on camera it doesn't, so I may need to go a bit darker so it actually shows on camera. Yeah, like this is what you're looking for. You're looking for a bit darker here. Okay, now this shows on camera. All right, this is what you're looking for, the darkness of a cherry. All right, great. Okay, now I'm gonna move lower and I'm gonna start with my cone. So the colors that I'm gonna be using for my cone are my golden brown and my dark brown. You could use all three for sure. You could use this brown as well, but really you could just get away with using two. So it's really up to you whether you want to use two or three. I would say start with two. If you don't like it, add a third one. It's not going to ruin it. It's going to add more complexity, and more complexity is always good. It's never a bad thing, but it is more work too. So really up to you whether you wanna do that or not. So what I'm gonna start with is I'm gonna start by shading from the edge in on both sides. And try not to get it too much on your paper here. So maybe we'll zone out our paper right away, so we don't have to go that far down. So we'll maybe a little tiny gradient from the paper up. You could totally go over your chocolate, that's not a problem. So I'm gonna add a little gradient here from the edge in. And a little gradient on the other side, so from the edge in as well. And I'm definitely going to smudge all of that. So I'm gonna grab a clean side of a Q-tip and I'm gonna smudge all of this to create a bit of a even surface to work with. And then once I have that, I'm gonna add a bit of gradient with my second color, with my darker brown, but not as much. So I'm not gonna push on my pencil as much. So I'm just gonna do it quite lightly. And now for anyone who wants, and this is not necessary, but for anyone who does want, to add a bit more complexity, we're gonna use a third brown. But again, you may not have as many browns too, so you don't need it. This is optional. But if you decide to use a third brown, you're gonna do the exact same thing. And again, you may only have one brown, and that's more than enough. And I'm gonna clean up the edges too. Sometimes when you do the shading, it gets places where you don't want it to get. So I'm gonna clean that all up. And again, I'm gonna grab my Q-tip. You can use the same one that you smudged your first layer with. And I'm gonna smudge that to create a bit more even layer. Great, I like my comb. And I'm gonna move on to the design. So again, I'm gonna start with the lightest color and I'm gonna start adding slightly curved lines on an angle like this. And you can push a little bit harder than what you did with your gradient. And the hardest, so the most visible part would be in the middle. So you should be pushing a bit hardest right here and then making it lighter on this side and that side. But that's again, that's the most ideal way. Not ideal, even if it's even line, that's okay. It's not a problem, but aim for having a bit of a more visible and darker spot in the middle. So you can even go over that area a couple more times to create a bit of a more visible spot. And with this particular pencil, I'm gonna add my lines quite wide. So do you see I'm not making them super thin? I could get them much, much thinner than that, but I'm intentionally not doing that. I'm intentionally making them a little more wide and, you know, almost foggy. So not super crisp, because this is my, again, it's my underlay color. And then I'm gonna do the exact same thing with the lines going the opposite direction, but again, they need to be slightly curved. Alright, so that's the first layer of our beautiful ice cream chrome texture. So now I'm going to move on to my second brown. Again, it's going to be this one, and I'm going to do it quite lightly too. Pretty much the same thing, but with those darker colors, you don't have to make your lines as wide. So here's, you can make them a bit more crisp. And again, for those, this is good, but for those who want to do the third layer, the third color, you can absolutely do that. So you can move on to your last brown and just do this again with your last brown. All right, and now I'm gonna darken up the edges again. So before I darkened up and it looked good, but now that we have this design, our edges need to be darker. So I'm gonna grab one of the browns or both of the browns, whichever, I mean one of the darker browns or both of the darker browns, and we're just gonna darken up the edges again a little bit. I'm not gonna be going as much in as I did before. We're just building an intensity a little bit more. And again, only if needed. If you feel like that your drawing doesn't need it, don't do it. It's only if it needs it. right, great. And again, I'm gonna clean up the edges, clean up my paper on the bottom. Done. So now I want to do this cone, and then I'm gonna do chocolate. So the cone is so simple. I'm just gonna use this cold brown, but you guys are welcome to use gray or black if you prefer that. That will work just as well. And I'm just gonna start by adding a very light outline, but it's gonna be more like a flicky outline, with certain areas being a little bit darker. So any corner, like this corner connection, can be a little bit darker, and the middles should be a little bit lighter. So you're almost making like flicks from the edges and corners. You see, pretty lightly overall. Yeah, just like that. Awesome. I'm gonna color in those two little corners there. And now I'm gonna shade very, very lightly from the edge in here. Super, super lightly. And from the edge in here as well. And here too. Alright, so do you see? I started having this round shape, which is great, and now I'm going to move on to my chocolate here. So I'm going to start with my warmer brown, and I'm going to color in the entire thing with my warmer brown. I would probably say I'm not going to go at 100% capacity of my pencil. I'm not going to go 100% pressure. I would probably go about 80% pressure. 80% of what my pencil is capable of. All right, then I'm going to Q-tip all of that. But again, try not to go on the edge. So just try to Q-tip only the middle of your chocolate. So try not to get to the edge of it, because you would like your edge to stay quite crisp. So you don't want to smudge that accent. But you know what? Actually, maybe I'll make it a little bit lower. You can't ruin it by having too much chocolate. It's never too much chocolate, right? How can you even have too much chocolate? It's not a thing. All right, now I'm gonna Q-tip just the middle part. Again, try to avoid your edge. And then I'm gonna grab my other brown, the darker brown, and I'm gonna start shading it from the edge in. So very similar to what I did everywhere else. You're gonna go to do a super, super dark edge and shade it lightly towards the inside. And again, certain areas you can shade the whole thing because you want to have it uneven as well. All right, and if after this you want to darken it up even more, again, mine looks a bit darker in real life than it does on camera for some reason. I think it's the way it's either camera autocorrects it or because maybe of how my light position that it glares, the darkest areas just don't show as dark as they are. But it needs to be a bit darker, so if needed, you can even involve straight black and do the same thing with straight black as your darkest color. But I'm looking at it, and you know what? I kind of want to fix up this bottom line. Now that I added this dark chocolate, this looks a little too dark. So I'm gonna go back to one of my pink pencils. Let's go to this one, so the second one. And I'm just gonna darken it up a bit more. Oh, yeah, I like that more. It's a little bit darker. Okay, and maybe I'll go to this last one too. This third guy here. Where is it? Here it is. We'll just add a bit more with that pencil too. Oh, nice. I am liking this. And after that, guys, you're done. Unless you want to add anything else to it, which you absolutely can. And you can add a bit of shadow, you can continue shading your cone, you can add a bit of decoration on the ice cream, you can add some sprinkles there, you can add some sprinkles, well, you can actually, you cannot add sprinkles on a chocolate unless you do them with like an acrylic paint or something that can go over your dark pencil, because light pencil, it just wouldn't go over your dark pencil. But because this is still almost white, you can add a lot of sprinkles here. You can add any other fruit behind, or maybe like a van or a cinnamon stick, or like a mint leaf behind, or honestly anything you want to add to it, you absolutely can. And then last thing that you have to do is you have to sign it. So choose a good spot and put your initials or anything else that you would like. I'm gonna sign mine right here. And we are officially done. I hope you guys enjoyed drawing with me today, and I sure hope I'll get to see some of your drawings. Please feel free to share them with us on Facebook. There's a link in the description of this event. So push on to description of event. You will find a Facebook group link there. So just feel free to post them there. We encourage everyone to post their results from our tutorials there so that everyone else who participated can see them. And it almost makes us feel like we did it all in the same room, even though we are all over the world. And guys, if you enjoy drawing with me, and you want to say thank you by tipping me, I will never say no to that. Don't feel like you have to, but if you want to, I am not going to stop you. And in the description of the video, there is a tipping link, it's a PayPal link, so feel free to use that one. And that's pretty much it. Stay tuned for more tutorials. Let's do this again next week. Bye, guys.